Thank you.
You're welcome.
Great job.
So what was it like for you, just for a young reporter to seek you out, ask you questions like that? Do you appreciate those moments?
Yeah, definitely. You know, I definitely appreciate those these moments. And I'm just trying to make his day, man. You know, obviously, that's what he chose to do moving forward. So, and I think he's going to always remember this moment.
In the first quarter, I couldn't help but notice there was like one possession where you went straight to your right with Christian Wood there. A couple possessions later, you decided to do the reverse. How much are you adjusting as the game is going along based on what the defense is giving you?
I'm just trying to get to a spot. I really don't really see what the defense is giving me. I'm just thinking I got to get to my spot. Sometimes I got to go right, sometimes I got to go left, sometimes I got to stop, pull over him. I'm just trying to read the defense, you know.
How important is it for you guys to start the last part of the season the way you did tonight and kind of set it up?
Really important, obviously, you know, coming after the All-Star break, not being sloppy, just coming, playing good basketball, being up by 30 in the half, that's big. Being able to win this game by 20. You know, we just pick it up from where we left from, and that's really good because, you know, it puts everybody, you know, in the same page. But we here to play good basketball, we're here to win, and, you know, we had a little break, but now let's get back to it.
At one point you blocked Christian Wood, and then you kind of got in his face a little bit. Obviously, you played a bunch of guys that you played with on the same team over the past few years. What was it like to go against all those guys?
It's fun, obviously. Love Christian Wood, love Tony Snell, Thon Maker, John Hansen. Steve Frazier's now on the team, but he was 2 weeks ago. But all those guys that I play with, they've been great teammates to me. And it doesn't matter where they are. Obviously, on the court, I'm going to try to do my job and try to block every shot, try to play hard. But at the end of the day, they're my brothers, and you know, I got their back, and we're going to smile. And we've had great moments together.
Giannis, obviously it's been a very special couple of weeks for you. How special was it to go out there in your first game after having a son? There had to kind of be a really cool feeling about that, wasn't there?
Yeah, it's a great feeling. Obviously, don't think about it as much. I just go out there and try to lock in and do my job. After the game, you know, I'll be a dad. I'll do all that. But obviously, you know, he's really young right now. I think my mom and my girlfriend put him in front of the TV so he can watch the game, but he's not really watching the game. So, but just being able to, you know, get a few pictures of him before the game, that makes me, you know, really happy. And it makes my job out there a lot easier, you know. And it's crazy how, like, you know, a lot of people say kids complicate things and they make you tired and all that. But I feel like for me, it just makes my job more clear. Like, I go out there, do my job, try to win a game, and then after that, I'm a dad. I want to go see my kid.
In the second half, they got a technical, and you were the one who took the technical free throw. That's not normally something that happens. What, you know, why were you?
Coach Brad, I think he kind of felt that I was a little bit frustrated, you know, from the whole game. Tried to go, you know, drive the lane, getting hit, bleeding, people, you know, talking trash and all that. And he was like, okay, shoot the free throw so I can calm down. And that helped me calm down, and I was able to come back in the fourth quarter and help the team.
Did you see Marcus Johnson's dunk, his birthday dunk over Tutu?
Amazing. I hope when I'm 64. He's 64, right? Mm-hmm. When I'm 64, I can dunk like that. That's crazy.
Did he actually
jump over the tacos, though?
Yeah, the two tacos.
Because I didn't see, I didn't see the video of the tacos. I think he stepped on the tacos. So
he ate the tacos after.
Okay, so I believe him.